The planet is really, really big, but the scientists of this marine paleoceanographic project are interested only in one specific point. Now keep zooming, yes, right there in the North Atlantic Ocean off the coast of Portugal, around 40 degrees north latitude, there is an underwater mountain called the Torres Sea Mount. Right in the center of it, a point only 10 centimeters wide, is what the researchers of the TOR project have been focusing on since 2013. So back to that teeny tiny point. At a depth of 5 kilometers, that tiny point is semi-isolated from the rest of the ocean by the ridges of the Torres Sea Mount, which are 2,200 meters deep, sort of like a gigantic swimming pool. The ridges act like a funnel to trap the sediment, so that means whatever is inside the seamount is less affected by the deep ocean currents, giving us a more accurate picture of the ocean's history. So now that you understand that this little point is basically a natural laboratory where researchers can test their scientific hypotheses, let's take a trip out into the ocean. In 2013, the researchers of the Spanish Geological Survey, in collaboration with Portuguese and French research institutions, went out on a research vessel to bring that tiny little point back to the laboratory. A long tube called a core was used to collect a sample of sediment from the bottom of the ocean. The 24 meters long tube was then brought back on board and cut into sections, much like you would cut a sausage, in order to study each section separately. All of the samples were then taken to the lab, where the researchers get together to have a sampling party. No, not a party like that, it looks more like this. Basically, the samples of sediment are divided up between the researchers to be used for different analyses. They have been studying the samples since 2018 when they received funding from the Spanish government. So, why do the researchers put so much time and effort into studying one tiny little section of sediment from the Torres Sea Mount?
Once we have the samples, we use a microscope to study these tiny shells of marine organisms called foraminifera. When they die, they sink to the ocean floor and form different layers of sediment that reflect the changing condition of the ocean surface.
Through studying the different layers, the researchers gather tons of data that they use to put together graphs and diagrams that help them to study aspects like primary production in ocean subtropical deserts, deep ocean ventilation, ocean acidification, the occurrence of turbidity currents away from continental margins, and the past temperatures of the ocean surface.
By looking closely at the sediment, we can study the past conditions of the ocean and the climate, and infer the patterns of change that we'll see in the future of Earth.
Understanding these patterns gives us an invaluable tool in the fight against the climate crisis. It allows us to distinguish between the natural variations in the climate and those that are caused by humans. And to think, all of this information comes from that one tiny little point at the bottom of the ocean.